I'm featuring this orchid that has no ID. It's a Dendrobium phalaenopsis, and I have featured it before last year. This is a light purple edge on the petals and white on the interior. It's a profuse bloomer. I didn't think I could get better than last year. That last year's bloom was just amazing. And I'll see if I can put a link to last year's video that featured this particular Dendrobium phalaenopsis. It's big, and it's funny, I had a hard time trying to prop this up for filming. I took a box of paper and wedged the orchid in between the wall and the box of paper, so just so I could keep it in place while it's filming. It's very top heavy. I couldn't find a pot that would hold the orchid without, it was so top heavy it kept falling over no matter what clay pot I had. But anyway, this is the best I can do. Normally I have it hung up and I don't have anything to hang up inside where I could film it easily. I usually hang it up outside, and I brought it in just for filming. Lots of buds. Tons and tons of buds. So there's four bloom spikes, and I'm so sorry, I'm not good at filming right here, so I'm gonna see if I can get the best shot I can to show you where the spikes are. So this particular spike, two of the spikes came from the middle, the apical part of this particular cane, and it is probably a little bit taller than the other one, this one. And the other one developed two spikes earlier than the other. So this one developed a little earlier than this one. But this one, I have a few flowers that fell off. That's why I went ahead and quickly filmed, because I was hoping to film when all the buds are open, but that's just not realistic timing, right? So two of these buds, I think, yeah, two fell off, and a few more came off of this stem right there. And the color fades a little bit after it's been open for a while. So but it's a fairly long bloomer in general, not too bad. I got it from Lowe's, and I think I might have mentioned that before, and it's I'm really happy with this purchase from 2 years ago. Just super happy. It was not a big plant. Let me see if I can zoom in when I purchased it. I think that was the size of it right there. That was that the cane that it came with. And then, well, let me see. Yes, it was, because this is the cane that I grew that last year, this height. And then this year is this cane and this cane. Okay. Let's see if I can come out. There's so much green on it, it's hard to depict what is what. So yeah, this cane this year, this cane this year, and this cane last year right here. This cane last year. So the cane it came with was that cane, and it was very pretty. So you see some of these sunburn, I call it. Yeah, there's sunburn. I did have it in very high sun, direct morning sun, and then I backed off some when I saw that. But no big deal, just a little burn, that's it. It's a very overall very, very healthy, robust grower, very, very easy to grow plant, just needs a good amount of light. And since it's such a fast grower, it does need quite a bit of fertilizing. I fertilize about every other week with Better Grow Orchid Mix, the I think 10-10-10, can't remember exactly. But it's just a straightforward orchid mix, no bloom enhancer in it or bloom plus or anything. And as far as fragrance, nothing really notable. There is a sweet floral fragrance when the sun hits it. All right. Oh, hey, this is a better shot. There you go. Okay, well, thank you so much for watching. Have a good day and happy orchid growing.